TV show you remember watching? Tiz Was, I remember that. I really liked Tiz Was.
Tiz Was good.
And then my dad let me stay up late to watch, they'd show repeats of Monty Python. I remember finding that funny that they would play with the form of television.
What was the show with the annoying kids running around being all precocious?
Why Don't You?
Yeah, I remember that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Sounds like you were judging them a little from
Here's
your reaction.
He's a talented journalist at the age of 9.
Because it was always little bastards, wasn't it, writing in, going, oh, dear, why don't you? I've got a collection of train sets or whatever. I don't care.
Scary shows as a kid. Tales of the Unexpected. Every week, a terrifying story, and you had no idea how it was going to end.
Mm-hmm.
That was delicious.
Yeah,
delicious.
Hammer House of Horror was another one. It was partly the fact that it was a sort of lo-fi British setting that made it even more eerie somehow. Yeah. I remember being scared of Crystal Tips and Alistair, which was a cartoon. Yeah, she had hair a bit like yours.
No, that's why you hate me so much.
I don't hate you, I just find you terrifying.
Okay.
And it's because of that. You know why? It was because her body could turn through 90 degrees without warning. Yes, much like that. That's quite chilling. Yeah, it's like being in a documentary about it. And Mary, Mungo and Midge as well, which was sort of eerie.
I don't know that one.
It was a bit eerie. Mary, Mungo and Midge?
Mm-mm.
A character that you identified with when you watched a show. Well, obviously, Captain Scarlet. Not because he's an indestructible hero, but because he's like stiff and awkward and can't even walk through a door properly.
Show you've re-watched the most?
Bandersnatch. Well, all the Black Mirrors, because we have to watch them again and again and again in the edit.
But not when they're delivered. Mm.
You know what? When I was a teenager, I watched The Young Ones again and again and again. And I wanted more of The Young Ones, so I wrote out the scripts by hand.
Because you thought by writing out the script you'd get more.
No, let's not characterise me as an idiot. It was just more that I want, you know, when you want more of your thing. And then I couldn't have got a Funko bobblehead of like Rick and Vivian.
Could
I?
Would you have bought
one? Yes, if I'd had the money at that age. What about you?
Rewatch the most, Fawlty Towers I've watched a
lot. That's a good one.
Always.
What's your favourite?
Which one?
Fawlty Towers.
I like
the one where Basil
gets. Inspectors.
Oh, the food inspector.
I like that one.
Yeah. What show first made you think I could do that?
The Olympics.
I don't know that many shows made me think I could do that. Lots of things made me think I wish I could do. Like The Day to Day, I remember was a show that I looked at that and thought, oh, that was the first time it was something that was a comedy show that was of my generation, it felt like, if you see what I mean. Show most influential on your writing? Twilight Zone, obviously, Tales of the Unexpected, Monty Python, not the 9 o'clock news, The Young Ones, Mad Men, Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul. There's loads, that's the thing. There's loads and loads and loads. Oddly, actually, probably the best answer to that is Ultimate Force, starring Ross Kemp. I saw a script for that, and it was one of the first times I'd sat down and read a TV script, and it had a description of a bit where Ross Kemp's character jumps on a motorbike and races away. And I realised it was like a penny dropping where I went, oh, right, so the stage direction bits are really important in a script because that's as important as the dialogue. Oh, what is the show you love people wouldn't expect you to be a fan of?
I know what yours is.
MasterChef?
Yeah.
MasterChef. You probably don't have an answer to this because you will not suffer fools gladly. What's the show you love people wouldn't...
I'm just suffering you gladly. I've occasionally watched a little bit of First Dates. Because it reminds me of a time when I went out.
Oh. Best ever single episode of a show.
Oh, God, that's specific.
I can think of something that sticks out in my head as one of the most tense moments of anything I've ever seen. It's an episode of Breaking Bad, and I cannot remember what it is called, but it's the one where Hank is in the...
Car park,
and the two twins are coming to get him. And it's like the whole set piece was astonishing.
Oh, that's a great episode.
That and there was a brilliant episode, Better Call Saul, actually. I don't want to spoil it.
Some of Narcos in season one.
Yep.
Season one was really good.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, that's a really good episode of Haunting of Hill House as well.
That's
very on brand. I was talking about Netflix.
Oh. What is the funniest show in history?
I'd probably put something like Brass Eye that I found incredibly. I couldn't believe it. Last show that you loved. Have you ever really loved the show?
I have loved Breaking Bad. Oh. I genuinely felt bereft when it stopped.
But why don't you need to watch more of Better Call Saul? It's a slower burn, it's a different beast.
I know, I gotta get into it.
I really enjoyed Money Heist, which was on Netflix, which was, even though it was ridiculous, but it sort of knew it was. So that was the last show. I really enjoyed The Haunting of Hill House as well. I really enjoyed Inside Number 9 because I was catching up on those recently. I think those are astonishingly clever and very well made.
Show you wish you'd made? Breaking Bad. Most well crafted shows that has ever been created.
I'd go along with that.
And Mad Men for its refusal to lean into pace, to, you know, that it's confidence, I would say.
To basically entertain. I'm joking because I love Mad Men.
Yeah. Most underrated show in history.
It's probably something we haven't seen because it got such terrible reviews.
Yeah.
Unjustly, that it was buried. I can't answer what the most underrated show in history is. I would say Better Call Saul is underrated at present, okay. I think. But what were you about to say?
No, what was the show on BBC 4 that you really liked?
Oh, there is, and that's made me remember that there was something that I got obsessed with and that one seemed to watch, and I can't... Oh, I don't know, I can't remember! It was really bloody good.
Oh, that's all right then.
Okay.
So that's answered.